So good afternoon, everyone. Thank you so much for joining us in today's webinar to learn more about the RREA National Focus Funds request for application. And today's webinar, next slide, Rocio. So this webinar will be recorded, and please make sure to mute your microphone. And if you have some technical issues related to the platform, here is the number to call, and make sure to press option 2. Throughout the presentation, you may type your questions in the chat box in this platform. And also, this webinar will be recorded and it will be posted to this website. We are going to be sharing with you this website so you can go back later on after the webinar if you learn more about the topics that we have discussed. Next slide. Here's a slide concerning the non-discrimination statement at USDA. In essence, USDA, in particular NIFA, we make our information available to the public without any regard to sex, orientation, or any forms of discrimination. So if you have difficulty accessing this information later on, we are happy to provide you with the right format. Next slide. So my name is Jomi Zamora. I am a national program leader for forest resource management with the Environmental Systems Division of the Institute of Bioenergy, Climate, and Environment of NIFA. Here is my contact information, and feel free to reach out to me if you have any questions about the webinar during or after the webinar. Rocio, would you like to introduce yourself?
Good morning and afternoon, wherever you are. My name is Rocio Gutierrez. I am the program specialist for the RREA and National Focus Funds program. And also my email is there if you have any questions during the webinar or afterwards, please feel free to email us. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Rocio. So next slide. So this is how the whole hour is going to be utilized. I recognize that there are time allocations in each of the section of the webinar, but we might not be able to really utilize this. But what we are going to cover today, first, I'm going to provide you an overview about NIFA. And second, to talk to you very briefly about the RREA program. And then we are going to look into details, the request for application for this particular RFA for the national program focus. And on that, we are going to be looking in details the evaluation process of how we do evaluation of the proposals that we receive. And then towards the end, we are going to be providing you additional information and resources that you might be that might be helpful as you prepare writing your grant application. Next slide, please. So let's look for some overview of NIFA. Essentially, NIFA, which is the National Institute of Food and Agriculture, is the extramural science funding agency within USDA's research, education, and economic areas. NIFA invests in and supports initiatives that ensure the long-term viability of agriculture. In order for us to do this, we collaborate with leading scientists, experts, and educators in organizations throughout the world to find innovative solutions to the most pressing local and global problems that we face. NIFA provides funding and strategic leadership for programs that ensure groundbreaking discoveries in agriculture-related sciences and technologies to reaching the people who can put them into practice. There are a number, next slide, please. There are a number of topics that NIFA programs covered. This includes advanced technologies. Examples of this are bioenergy, biotechnology, and nanotechnology, animals, business and economy, natural resources, of which the RREA program belongs to, and under natural resources, we deal on forest, grassland, and rangeland soil, water, and air issues. Education, we serve, we provide funding for minority serving institutions, providing funding to for learning and teaching, as well as workforce development. Environment is another topic covered by NIFA. We cover topics related to climate change, ecosystems, invasive species, and diseases. Farming and ranching, human sciences, food science, food and nutrition security, international programs, as well as plants. If you could see, NIFA essentially covers a breadth of disciplines. And we address all these things through different competitive and capacity grant programs. Next slide, please. Now, we are going to be looking at the RREA National Program Focus. RREA actually is called Renewable Resource Extension Act. The RREA was enacted in 1978 to provide for an expanded and comprehensive extension program focused on forest and rangeland renewable resources. So the RREA National Program, National Focus Fund is established primarily to enhance the sustainability of forest and rangeland resources. Second, to enable landowners and managers to achieve desired goals by making public research available to them. Third, maximize the capacity, reach, and impact of the cooperative extension system, particularly the Extension Forestry and Rangelands Program, to ensure appropriate management and conservation of natural resources and resilience against climate change. So in essence, the RREA National Program Focus Funds are used to support projects that will expand the reach extension, the reach of extension forestry and rangeland resources through coordination and delivery and use of innovative technologies and extension program models that can be easily replicated by other institutions, states, and region. Next slide, please. So for fiscal year 2023, the RREA National Focus Fund Program is soliciting applications in the following priority areas. We invite applications that address or that supports extension projects to ensure the adoption of climate smart technologies and practices in forest systems. Second, we invite applications that support extension projects that ensure the adoption of climate smart technologies and practices in rangeland systems. As I have mentioned earlier, RREA focuses on forest systems and rangeland systems. So for this year, RFA, we invite application that supports extension activities in forest systems as well as rangeland systems, particularly to ensure the adoption of climate smart technologies and practices in these systems. These priorities that we identified essentially are aligned on the USDA strategic goals. So let us look at the eligibility of the program. We solicit applications for the RREA National Focus Fund Program from 1862 and the 1890 land grant institutions only. These are the only qualified institutions that can apply to the RREA National Focus Program. Project directors must have an extension appointment. An extension appointment is a formal appointment by an extension director, administrator in the institution's extension service. And duplicate submissions or multiple applications by the same PD are not allowed. However, we allow application, multiple applications from the same institutions. The RREA National Focus Fund has no matching requirement. Next slide, please. So as I have indicated earlier, we anticipate to award one research to address priority number one, forest system, and we anticipate to award one award for rangeland system. Make note that RREA is only for extension activities. We do not support research project under this RFA. And grant type is standard, and generally grant duration is about 24 months. So what, next slide, please. So what are the activities that we support? One, we support projects that will build on and expand existing extension efforts in forest and rangelands management that advance climate smart technologies. Second, the application of technological innovations to increase adoption of climate smart technologies and practices are something that we support as an activity for this particular round of RFA. These technological innovations include application of artificial intelligence with virtual realities, among other things. We support projects where extension efforts that, when adopted, provide social, economic, and environmental benefits. Details of the supported activities are described in the request for application, particularly on page 7. Next slides, please. So the proposed projects must implement new and innovative technologies into extension activities that maximize the adoption of climate smart technologies and practices that would result in behavior change among forest owners and rangeland owners, including the managers. Proposed projects must include a detailed plan on how data and information will be collected, including the extent to which climate smart technologies and practices have been adopted by forest and rangeland managers, which essentially are the target audience for this particular program, and activities including the results of behavior changes and economic benefits and changes in climate-related metrics. Next slide, please. So As I have mentioned earlier, under this particular program, RREA, which is designed for extension activities only, we do not fund projects that would conduct research under this particular request for application. We do not fund activities that construct or build facilities, and any activities that would require purchase of equipment. These are all discussed in detail in page 14 of the RFA. Next slide, please. As I have earlier mentioned, this particular program does not require any matching of fund. And matching of fund will not be factored into the review process as evaluation criteria. So take note of this particular requirement. Next slide, please. We're going to talk to you now about some details in documents that you really need to prepare as part of the application package. For, as I have mentioned, RFA is available online. The RFA details all the information regarding the application, and feel free to reach out to us after this presentation if you have any more questions about the RFA. These are the different places where the RFA can be found. Please note that the deadline for application for this particular RFA is on May 8, 2023 at 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time and it should be submitted through grants.gov. We do not accept applications that are emailed to us. So you have to follow the system to submit your package or packet of application through the grants.gov. For this year, we are anticipating to have $300,000 available to fund activities for FY2023. And the maximum funding per award is $150,000, one for forest system and one for rangeland system. There are no restrictions in terms of the proposals that we receive from institution, and there is no restriction as well in terms of the number of proposals that we will award to institution. Next slide, please. In the RFA, we discuss key documents that you really have to submit as part of your application packet. These key documents that we require include project summary, which is essentially a section that you must show how the project goals align with the goals of the RREA National Focus Fund. Another section in your application is project narrative, which I'm going to be discussing that we require in the next coming slide, and bibliography or reference list that you have used in developing your grant application, as well as other documents which are listed in the RFA, particularly on NIFA grants application guide. So here are the resources that you need to take note. Next slide, please. For the project narrative, take note of the page limit. It is 12, and it will be strictly enforced. This 12 limit must have a 1.5 spacing and must use 12 point times Roman font. And the 12 limits includes text, figures, and tables, and tables may be single space in not less than 11 point times Roman font. Within the project narrative, here is a list of the different sections that you really have to include in the project narrative. The title. You must provide an appropriate title for the project. Subtitle, that means that you really have to state the priority that you are trying to write or submit for, or that the proposal addresses. And this can be found in section C, part one of the request for application. The introduction, it should include a clear statement of the long-term goals, supporting objectives for the proposed project, in the nature of the issue that the project is intended to address. Justification, rationale, and significance section of the narrative should concisely present the justification for why this project is important to forest and rangeland owners and managers at a national or regional scale and how they will benefit. Under this particular section, you have to demonstrate feasibility of the project through preliminary data and include the detailed plan and how data will be collected during the execution of the project. Under the relevant literature review section of the narrative, you need to provide a concise review of recent relevant literature that supports the need for and importance of the project. Objectives, it must be clear, concise, complete, and logically arranged objective statements. Approach, I would like you to look on page 13 of the RFA for details. And the last section under project narrative, which is the project sustainability and replication, you have to discuss it, and this is required. Describe plans for assessing another institution's states or regions in replicating the project, and describe any plans for sustaining the project beyond the life of the project. Please note that applications exceeding the page limit will be returned without review. So you have to be mindful of the page limit that we require under this RFA. Next slide, please. As I have mentioned earlier, we only accept electronic submissions via the grants.gov. And here is a link of the application guide that I encourage you to download that will help you in preparing for writing of your grant application. Please note that application documents must be in portable document PDF format. And we don't accept other format other than PDF in your application, including narrative and budget justifications. So please, next slides, please. So how are we going to evaluate the proposals once we receive here in NIFA? NIFA evaluate each application in two-part process. First, we will screen each application to ensure that it meets the administrative requirements set forth in this RFA. All administrative requirements must be met for the application to proceed to the next level of review. Second, a scientific peer review process will be used to technically evaluate applications that have met the administrative requirements using the review panel. So once we receive your application and pass through the administrative reviews, then your proposal will then be assigned to at least three reviewers with expertise in the proposed topics. Each reviewer will be given ample time to review your application to produce individual review that includes evaluation of the strengths and weaknesses of your proposal. And then these written reviews are then used to begin panel discussion with other reviewers serving on the peer review panel. So what I am trying to discuss over here, after a certain period of time of individual review, we will then convene the whole panel to discuss the ratings, the reviews of individual proposals, and the whole panel will then have the opportunity to review, deliberate about the merits of your proposal. The panel will then use these discussions to come up with consensus on the final rating and ranking of the proposals. So essentially, that is the whole evaluation process that we employ in NIFA. Next slide, please. If you are intending to apply for this RFA, please pay attention to the evaluation criteria for this particular program that we have listed in page 16 of the RFA. Here are the evaluation criteria that we will be using to evaluate your proposals. Project justification. The issue that your project will address is well-defined and describes. That is what we are going to be looking for. How you are convincing the panel to ensure that the issue that you are proposing will address the issues, the priorities of the program. It should be well-defined and well-described. Project merit. Project merit involves evaluating the proposal's objectives, outputs, outcomes, and impacts, making sure that they are clearly described, adequate, and appropriate. So I don't have to list down or discuss all of these because these are all listed in the RFA. I encourage you to look at those things. I would like to have plenty of time to answer your questions. That's why please go back to the RFA and examine every details of the criteria in each of these four major evaluation metrics that we are going to be using in evaluating your proposals. Next slide, please. So this is what you will expect in terms of the timeline for this particular request for application. 1 to 2 months, we usually release the application, request for application, and we allow proposal writing, proposal writing and planning under this time period. And right now, you are in this stage. And proposal due for this particular program, as I have mentioned earlier, is going to be on May 8th. After May 8th, you expect that NIFA will conduct peer review process and we will notify successful proposals under this time period. After this one, we will then finalize the awards and make the awards available to the successful candidates. On average, a competitive program within NIFA takes about 3 to 4 months from the proposal due date to an award being made to an institution. So we will keep you updated as much as possible. So please, wait for us, and we really appreciate your patience. Next slide, please. Here is another slide. Next slide, please, Roshan. I would like you to visit the CRIS, which is a database of funded projects within USDA to find out if of similar projects that you would like to propose under this priority. I'm sure this is going to be very useful for you because it will guide you or tell you information that we found under this particular program over the past few years. Next slide, please. So we would like you to be continuously aware of the upcoming events and activities at NIFA. Click this link to find out the upcoming deadlines, meetings, and webinars for other applications that might be of interest to you. And here is also a list of listing the different applications, RFA, that will be coming up in the pipeline in the near future that might be of interest to you as well. Next slides, please. So I would like you to really consider visiting these different websites, these links, or resources. These are very useful resources in your grant application development. So please take advantage of these resources that we have listed for you. Next slides, please. So again, my name is Jomi Zamora, and Rocio is here, a program specialist for the RREA program. And we are here to answer any questions you might have. Thank you so much. Are there any?
For now, we don't have any in the chat or in the Q&A portion, but if attendees have any questions, please let us know. We're going to be here for another few minutes.
Feel free to unmute yourself if you need to, or type your questions in the chat box.
It is also okay if everything seems now clear, but when you visit the links and the RFA guide and the RFA itself, and if you get any questions, please always feel free to email Jomi or myself. This recording and the PowerPoint presentation will be posted. So please, you will have our information to send your questions.
Yeah. Again, I would like to emphasize that our doors are open. You can reach out to us, email or by phone, and we can talk more about any questions and address them the best we can.
So we have one question, Jomi. It says, you're only going to fund two proposals, one forestry and one rangeland. Regardless of the value of proposals, you will only fund two proposals?
Correct. So that is the priority right now. We are going to fund one proposal on forest system that address climate smart agriculture through extension, and one proposal that would address climate smart agriculture in rangeland system. For this particular fiscal year, anyhow. Any other questions? Feel free to unmute, and we're happy to converse with you.
There is another one. Does the PI need to be coming from a higher education institution or extension? Is this a requirement?
So again, the basic eligibility of the PI, it must come from 1890 or 1862 institutions and must have an extension appointment issued by the cooperative extension. Any more questions?
I don't see any other. Maybe we can wait another minute.
Any more questions? Well, hearing none. So again, thank you so much for joining in today's presentation. And please do not hesitate to reach out to us for any questions that you have about the application, RFA, and we look forward to receiving applications from you. We are here to provide you resources the best we can.
Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you, Shelly.
Thank you, Shelly.
Thank you.